The fast life to track and field. This his fourth round attempt. Tommy's got that low trajectory when he jumps so fast. Once placed in the 200 meters at the NCAA championships, fourth round he moves into second place with a leap of 57 feet 1 inch. He's one of the great comeback performers. With two jumps left, Mike Conley is dangerous. So Edwards now calmly into his final three jumps. A little bit more secure that now he's made a final. The world record holder and world champion, just under 6 feet and 154 pounds, but they say one of the strongest men on the British track team. He runs full speed down the runway. His fourth round jump, a very big one. He looks back to see the white flag raised, and he knows it's a long one. Past the board, where 18 meters is not even written on this board, which amazes me considering the people in this final. Look at how intense this man is. He has outstanding technique, barely collapses on each one of the phases. He looks at the board on the way into the pit and breaks the sand cleanly. And Edwards, 58-8, and into second place, pushing Conley down to the bronze medal, but he still knows he's behind Harrison. This is Yoelvi Quesada of Cuba, who has scared the world record a couple times himself. He's had trouble with some hamstring problems, ankle problems in 1996. This his fourth round jump. Huge contrast to Edwards, much longer and very fast on the runway. And out past that 17 meter mark, which is 55.9. And Quesada moves into the bronze medal position, displacing Conley by an inch and three quarters. So then it was Harrison, who was still leading the competition with an Olympic and American record on his first jump. He fouled on his second and passed on his third. He was once told by Willie Banks to get off the runway back at the 1984 Olympic trials. And now he has Banks's American record. And on the fourth jump, Harrison looks out and says, maybe that's even improvement over my first one. Harrison just 5 feet 10 inches, very intense, jumps completely differently from any other triple jumper in this country, and certainly differently from Jonathan Edwards. Does he love this runway? And into a slight headwind once again, another American in Olympic record, 59 feet 4 and a quarter, the third longest jump, legal jump, in history. So Kenny Harrison still way out in front, Edwards second, and Quesada of Cuba holding down the bronze medal position. Conley just an inch and three quarters out of that third place spot. He is dangerous, the last two. Tom, this man, Kenny Harrison, still sitting pensively, even though he has set two American records and two Olympic records in this triple jump competition. He knows that he doesn't have it wrapped up, because this man, Mike Conley, is the greatest comeback competitor in triple jump history. He is the defending Olympic champion, and even though he hurt his right hamstring trying to make the long jump team last month, you can never count this man out. His last trip down the runway at the Olympics, he looks back and sees the red flag fly. A silver in LA, a gold in Barcelona, but fourth place here in Atlanta for the 33-year-old from Fayetteville, Arkansas. But Harrison still paced, because next up on the runway was the world record holder, Jonathan Edwards of Great Britain, the only man to ever jump over 60 feet, the world champion. A 21 meet winning streak on the line, 58-8 in the fourth round in this competition. Could he pull it out? Could he put the pressure back on Harrison? Full speed down the runway for Edwards, and a very long effort, but he looks back at the board and sees the same thing as Conley, the red flag. We'll never know what the measurement was on that jump, because he missed by a half an inch on the board. But he's got to be happy. A silver medal after twice not even making the final in the Olympic triple jump. So all that was left for Kenny Harrison was all that was left for Mike Conley 4 years ago. Conley had already outdistanced the competition. All he had left to do was go after the world record. Harrison has the Olympic record and the American record. Now he wants the world record. 31-year-old from Milwaukee, Wisconsin, down the runway for the last time, but you can see at the board, that he was over, it was a foul, but he had done what he said was all that was missing in his trophy case, the Olympic gold medal. The injuries that this man has suffered through over the last 6 years, poised on the brink of triple jump stardom in the early 90s. And there's the man who holds the world record, who accomplished his dream of jumping 60 feet. But maybe Harrison isn't finished. At just 31 years of age, he's got some of his best years ahead of him. And he celebrates, as always, with a backflip for the crowd. And a souvenir to take home to put in his trophy case along with that gold medal. A little bit of the sand from the Olympic triple jump pit where he won his most coveted gold medal. Harrison wins the gold with an Olympic record. Edwards the silver, and Yoelvi Quesada of Cuba the bronze.
All right, thank you, Dwight. And so the triple jump concludes an eventful day two of track and field. One of the highlights of last night's competition was the victory by Kenny Harrison in the triple jump, embracing there Jonathan Edwards, the world champion and world record holder who claimed the silver medal in last night's competition. Harrison setting an Olympic and American record with a leap of 59.4¼, not counting that impressive backflip after claiming the victory. And why not? A souvenir on the landing pit sand that he'll place in his trophy case along with the gold medal. Didn't get the gold medal until tonight, though, because of a thunderstorm. He took the medal stand a little earlier this evening.
From the United States of America.
Mesdames et messieurs, veuillez vous lever pour l'hymne national des États-Unis d'Amérique.
Evening for Kenny Harrison and his girlfriend Gail Devers, who also collected her gold medal tonight.